Kings and Lord of Lords. The title of the message this morning is No Man Knows the Day or the Hour. And if the camera looks over here for just a second, I have some dates on this board. Anybody knows where we're going with this preaching? I already give you the title, so you probably know where we're going with this preaching. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Well, I have some dates right here on this board. And let's go to the scripture on Matthew 24, verse 6 to 15. And we're also going to go to Luke chapter 21, verse 28. Keep me in your prayers. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Thank you for watching YouTube and social media. We have some troubles with our camera on YouTube. That YouTube don't allow me to do live YouTube because I don't have 1,000 subscribers. So if you watch this video, subscribe to my channel on YouTube. It's called Repent Today, so we can do live videos on YouTube again. Matthew 24, verse 6 to 15. You know this this chapter very well, I hope, if you study the Bible and read the Bible. And ye shall hear of wars and rumors of wars. See that ye be not troubled, for all these things must come to pass, but the end is not yet. For nations shall rise against nation, and kingdom against kingdom, and there shall be famines and pestilence and earthquakes in diverse places. Verse 8. All these are the beginning of sorrows, beginning of pain labor. Then shall they deliver you up to be afflicted, and shall kill you, and shall be hated for all nations for my name's sake. Later, I'm going to preach on this verse. I'm going to make emphasis on this verse, so keep it in mind. Verse 10, and there shall be many be offended, and shall betray one another, and shall hate one another. Verse 11, and many false prophets shall rise and shall deceive many. And because iniquity shall abound, the love of many shall wax cold. Verse 13, but he that shall endure unto the end, the same shall be saved. Amen. And this gospel of the kingdom, and this gospel of the kingdom shall be preached in all the world for a witness unto the nations, and then shall the end come. Verse 15, when ye therefore shall see abomination of desolation spoken by Daniel the prophet, stand in the holy place, whosoever readeth, let him understand. Verse 21, Luke 21, 28, real quick in your Bibles. And when these things begin to come to pass, then look up and lift up your heads, for your redemption draweth nigh. It's near. It's coming soon. We already prayed for this message, so we're going to go straight into the message. So Matthew 24 right here, they give us a bunch of events that are going to take place before the end. And man loves to predict the end of the world. Many religious leaders of cults and sects have predicted the end of the world. And many people with PhDs and diplomas like Richard Dawkins, Matthew Kako, Lawrence Krauss, and Bill Nye, people who don't believe in God and they believe on science, and like them, had predicted the end of the world. I have some dates over here on this board written down, and I'm just going to give you what the scripture says. Bible says on Matthew 24:36, but the day and the hour no man knoweth, not even the angels, but my Father only. He's the only one who knows when it's coming to an end, when this war is going to end. So let's start with the first date, 1891. The Mormons, Joseph Smith, proclaimed that in 1891 it was going to be the end of the world. This is 2020, and it's not the end of the world. Now, 1910, let me see if I pronounce this right, hail is, hail is coming, was supposed to pass through the air. It was not even going to touch the air. It was just going to pass through the air. And this comet is massive. It has a radius of 7 miles. So you can imagine how big this thing is. And it was not going to crash the air. It was just going to pass so close to the air that people believe with the chemical, with the material that this comet has dragging himself with the gases, that it was going to kill the population. It was going to extend the animals and the population of this world. So people stuff their chimneys and cover their windows and their doors because they are afraid of the chemicals and the poisons of this comet passing near the air. Some people were even selling masks and selling pills that it was going to keep you alive. People taking advantage of all these things. Praise the Lord. 1914, anybody knows 1914? Russell, the man, the leader of the false Jehovah's Witnesses, he predicted the end of the world on 1914. Again, this is 2020, and we're still over here. Now, we get to more modern day end of the world predictions. 1997, there is a sect, a cult named Heaven's Gate. And what these people believed is that the UFOs and the extraterrestrial people were going to come down and they were going to destroy the planet and they were going to recycle the planet into something else. Oh. So what these fools did, they killed themselves, because by them killing themselves in 1997, I believe it was in October, their souls were going to go, they were going to get caught up into heaven with the UFOs, and they were going to be in heaven in a different planet or something like that. So that was their prediction. Then we get to another modern-day prediction, Y2K, on 2000. Remember, people were running around and scared because the computer was going to crash, and the stock market was going to crash, and everything was going to crash because of the Y2K in 2000. The end of the world was coming. Then we get to June 6th, the month 6th, the day 6th, 2006 will equal 666, the number of the beast. And many people thought that on that day, the end of the world was coming. Again, this is 2020. Whoever made that prediction was wrong. It's a fool. Don't read the Bible. Now, we get to 2012. My daughter was talking about this one this morning. The Mayans, the Mexicans, predicted that the end of the world was going to happen on December 21st, 2 days after my birthday, on 2012, because the Mayan calendar was coming to an end. I don't have this one here, but in 2017, somebody predicted the planet X was going to crash with the Earth, and that was going to be the end of the world after the eclipse on 2017. 2020, we're still here. Then we get to 2060. Isaac Newton comes and takes the Bible and reads the book of Daniel, and he says that the end of the world is coming on 2060. Very close. All right? Then we get